welcome to my playground, Smart ASL. I created this playground to teach anyone who uses it the American Sign Language alphabet. So let's get started. On the right-hand side, we have two images, one from the user's point of view and one from the camera's point of view. And as soon as I make that sign, it should be able to detect it and move on to the next letter. So let's give it a try. So as you can see, it detected the letter A, and now we're on to B. And on the camera scene, you'll notice several different views. At the bottom right, we have the output of the first model I'm using, which detects the hands. And sometimes it doesn't work very well, especially when there are too much skin. And it freezes as well, as you can see. And I'm not too sure why it freezes, but it does that sometimes. So now we're back, and we're continuing to detect a hand. And so after the hand is detected, the original image is cropped according to where the hand is. And that image is now then passed to the model that I trained that classifies the sign into a letter, which you can see above that. So above right here. When the letter is detected is at least 50% confidence, it will move on to the next letter. So I don't know if it will detect B. Seems like it's cutting off some. Oh, there you go. So now we're on to C. There you go. And on the top right hand corner here of the view, you have the alphabet chart. And when you tap on that, it should jump to the letter automatically. So now we're on O because I tapped the letter O, and we're gonna do the letter O. So, and there you go. So now that I feel like I've learned enough, I'm gonna go over to the quiz view and assess my ability. So here, the camera view is the same, and it's asking me for the hand sign for the letter T. So hopefully it can detect that. And sometimes if it doesn't detect it very well, I will try to adjust my hand slightly so that the camera sees it at a different angle, and hopefully that will be able to pick it up. But since it's not doing it, I'm going to skip that letter by tapping the skip button. And when I skip it, it's going to add it to the skip section at the bottom. So we can try J. And then any letter that I get right will get added to the section at the bottom right-hand corner where it says correct. And whenever there's a sign that I can't remember, I can always get a hint by tapping on the blue question mark, and it will show me the image of what the sign looks like. So there's that, but I'm going to skip this. So now we are at L. Let's see if it can detect L. So one downside about using this model is that sometimes it doesn't detect any finger that is extended. It detects the fist pretty well, but not any finger that is up. So as you can see here. And of course, with a better model and a better data set, it will do that better. So let's skip that letter. So you can see for the letter I as well, since the pinky is extended, it doesn't really pick that up. Okay, well, now that I feel like I'm done assessing my ASL skills, I'm going to stop this quiz. And when I press stop, it's gonna show me my score. So it looks like I got 1 out of 6 letters correct. And 6 because I only went through 6 letters and I had skipped 5. So we can try it again, or we can just go back to the main view. And that's the extent of this app. And thank you very much for watching. And I hope everyone who's learning ASL is having a great time. Bye-bye.